Today we will start with the n jobs on 3 machines. Here we are having the total 6 number of jobs and 3 machines are there. Machine A is the turning machine, machine B is the threading, and machine C is the knurling operation. We have to perform in the same sequence, that is A, B, C. Okay, and these are the processing time for the machine A, processing time for machine B, and processing time for the machine C. For n jobs on 3 machines, we don't have the algorithm to write the sequence directly. Hence, we have to convert these 3 machines into 2 machines. And before converting that one, we have to see the one here. We are having the one condition that first we have to select the what is the least processing time on machine A. Least processing time on machine A. That is how much? That one is 2. Okay. Next, highest processing time on machine B. Highest processing time on machine B, that is equal to 8. Again, we will come to the machine C. Least processing time on machine C. Least processing time on machine C, that is equal to 8. Okay. First thing is we have to identify the least processing time and the highest processing time for the machine A, C and B. Okay. After that, we are having one condition. Condition is that processing time on machine A is, that is least processing time on machine A is greater than or equal to highest processing time on machine B. This is the first condition. And second condition is least processing time on machine C is greater than or equal to highest processing time on machine B. Out of these two conditions, if any one condition is satisfied, then we can convert this 3 machine job into 2 machine job. Otherwise, we cannot convert that or we cannot solve the problem. Okay. Here the least processing time on machine A is, that is 2. Okay. And the highest processing time is 8. Okay. And here that condition is not satisfied because this one is 2 is not greater than or equal to 8. Hence, first condition is not satisfied. Next, we will go to the second condition, that is least processing time on machine C. Least processing time is on machine C is 8. Okay, is greater than or equal to highest processing time on machine B, that is again 8. Okay, yes, this condition is satisfied. Now we have to convert this n jobs on 3 machines into n jobs on 2 machines case. Okay, next we have to convert that n jobs on 2 machine case. Next, here we are having the 2 machines means we will consider the 2 machines as G and H. To find out the processing time on G and find out the processing time on H, what we have to do, we have to add the processing time on A plus processing time on B to get the machine G, and machine H, processing time on B and processing time on machine C. Then we will get the processing time on the H job. Okay. First, we will add these two things. That is 8 plus 3 is 11, 12 plus 6 is 18, next 9, 5 plus 4, 6, 2 plus 6, 8, 9 plus 3, 11, okay, 11 plus 1, 12, okay, next 8 plus 13, that is 21, okay, 6 plus 14, 20, next 9 plus 4, 13, next 12 plus 6 18, okay, 8 plus 3 11, and 13 plus 1 14. Okay, now we have got the machine 2 machines n job. Okay, now we have to find out the sequence for this particular 2 machine and n number of jobs, 6 number of jobs. To find out the sequence out of this, in this box we have to find out the least processing time. If the least processing time on machine G, then we have to write that job towards left side. If the least processing on machine H, then we have to write that job towards extremely right. Okay, first least processing time is 8 here, okay, on the machine G and job 4. Hence we will write the job 4 first, okay, and we can just discover the fourth row. Okay, next least processing time is 9, that is for the job 3. We will write the 3 here. Again we can discover the, this particular thing. Okay, after the 9 we are having the least processing time, that is the 11. 11 is on G, so, and one more 11 is on, that is G and H. And so what I will do, we can select any one here, there is no problem at all. I will select the 1 towards left side and 5 at the end I will select. Okay, there is no problem at all. And we are left with the only 2 jobs. Here the least processing time is again 12, that is on the machine G. Hence I will write the 6 here. Okay, and last finally we will write the 2. Okay, this is the sequence we have got now, that is 4, 3, 1, 6, 2, 5. Next I will write the that sequence here, that is 4, 3, 1, 6, 2, 5. Okay, next we will write the machine A in and out, machine B in and out, machine C in and out, we have to write. To write the machine A in and out, by default we have write this value as 0. Okay, next for the fourth job, what is the value we are having for the machine A? 2. 0 plus 2, it is 2. Okay, and write here again 2. For the third job, 5 is the processing time. 2 plus 5, 7. Okay, write the 7 here. Next, 7 here. Next for the 1, 7 plus 3, 10. Okay, next for the 6th, 11. 10 plus 11, 21. Okay, next second one, that is 21 plus 12, 33. Okay, next 33 plus 9, 42. This is for the machine A. Okay, next we have write the same thing for the machine B and machine C. Machine A, machine C. Okay, here the in time, we have to take this value as the in time, that is 2. Okay, for the fourth job, what is the time we are having? 6. 6 plus 2. 6 plus 2 is 8. Next, fourth, third job, we have to write out of these two which is the highest. 8 we have to write here. Okay, for third job, 4 is there. 8 plus 4, 12. Okay, again we have to write the 12 here. Okay, this is the 1. 1 means 8 again, 20. Okay, here this is 20, 21. We have to write the 21 here. Okay, 21, again 6 means 1, 22. Okay, but here we have to write the 33, because this is the highest value. 33 plus 6, 39. Okay, 39, 42. We have to write the 42. Okay, 42 plus 5, 4 plus 3. 3 means 45. This is for the second machine. Similarly, we have calculated for the third machine also, that is machine C. Again, here we have write the 8 as the in. Okay, for fourth job, what is the processing time for the machine C? 12. 8 plus 12 is 20. Here 12 is there, but we have write the 20. Okay, for third job, 9, 29. For first job, again we have write here 29 plus 13. 29, 39, 40, 42. Okay, here again we have write the 42. 42 plus 13, 55. Okay, again here we have to write the 55 plus 14, 69, okay, 69 again we have to write here, 69 plus 8, that is 77, okay, this is for the, and here the total elapsed time is 77 hours, okay, 77 hours we will consider, that is total elapsed time is equal to, total elapsed time is equal to 77, okay. Next we have to calculate the idle time for A, idle time for B and idle time for C. To calculate that one, first we have to calculate the, what is the total processing time on A, processing time on B and processing time on C we have to calculate. Processing time on A is, just we have to add the all these values, 3 plus 12, 15, 20, 22, 22, 31, 42, this is the total processing time is 42. Next here on B, 8 plus 6, 14, 18, 24, 27, 28. Okay. On machine C, 27, 36, 48, 56, 79. This is the total processing time for the machine C. Okay, to calculate the idle time on machine A, what we have to do? Total elapsed time minus total processing time. Okay, then similarly here also, total elapsed time minus processing time for that particular machine. Just I have made a small mistake here. This value is 69. Okay, and the total elapsed time is 77. And to find out the idle time, that is 7 minus 2 is 5, 7 minus 4 is 3. For the idle time on machine A is 35, and idle time on machine A is 7 minus 8. 9 and 3 means 49. Okay, here 77 minus 69 means 8. Okay, these are the idle time for the machine A, machine B and machine C. Okay, just I want to summarize the all this thing once again. Here the main thing is we have to find out the total elapsed time and the idle time on machine A, machine B and machine C. Okay, here they are given the three machines, that is machine A, machine B and machine C. This is for the turning, threading and knurling. Okay, first what we have to do, we have to convert the three machines into two machines. Okay, to convert the three machines into two machines, first thing is we have to observe the this processing time. We have to observe the processing time. In the first machine, the least processing time we have to observe. Okay, in the last machine, that is machine A and machine C, we have to select the least processing time. In machine B, we have to select the highest processing time. Okay, and we have one condition, that is least processing time on machine A is greater than or equal to highest processing time on machine B, or least processing time on machine C is greater than or equal to highest processing time on machine B. Okay, out of these two, if any one condition is satisfied, then we can convert this three machine problem into two machine problem. Otherwise, we cannot convert the three machine problem into two machine problem. Yes, to find out that one, again, here we have to find out the machine G and H. How we are finding out the machine G and H? G means just we have to add these processing times for the particular jobs. Okay, here 3 plus 8 is 11, 18, 9, 8, 12, again. 11, 12. Okay, like that we have to write. Here also just I made the mistake here. This is 9 plus 3 is 12. Okay, sorry for that one. And this is also final. And to calculate the H machine, again we have to add the these two things. Okay, like that we have to write the things. Next, we have to write the this table. First thing is we have to write the job. Next for the machine A, machine B and machine C. Whatever sequence we have got here, we have read that sequence here as it is. There is no changes at all. Okay. Next, to write the machine A in and out, first thing is by default we have to take this time as 0. Okay. For the fourth job, what is the time we are having? 2. 0 plus 2. 2. Okay. Next, for the third job, whatever the value is there, we have to write that value here as it is. Okay. For the third job, 5 is the time. 2 plus 5. 7. Next, we have to write this value as it is. Likewise, we have to calculate for the all these jobs. Okay. Next, when we come to the machine B, first we have to take the in time as the, what is the out time for the first job is there, we have to take that time as the in time. Next, we have to compare these two values. Okay, here this is 7 and 8. We have to write highest value, 8. This is 10 and 12, 12. 21, 20, 21 we have to write. 33, 22, we have to write 33. 39 and 42, we have to write the 42. Out of that two values, which value is the highest one? We have to write the that value. Similarly, here also same thing. Here this out time will become the in time for the machine C. Okay. Next, for that we have to add the again processing time. Again, while writing this value, we have to see that these two values. This is 20, 12. We have to write the 20. 29, 20. 29 we have to write. 22, 42. We have to write the 42. 39, 55. We have to write the 55. 45, 69. We have to write the 69. Like that we have to write and we have to add the processing time. Finally, we will get the total elapsed time as 77, and the idle time on machine A is 35, and the idle time on machine B is 49, and the idle time on machine C is 8 minutes. Okay, that depending on that one, we have to run through. Thank you.